The Censorship of David Paulides. And why it's critical, not just important to you. A few days ago, he was given a strike on his YouTube. I believe speaking about the COVID, suicide rates, just facts, and just one key point that he made even recently was that how kids are. I think the recent one he said was that kids in Germany were committing suicide and likely to be associated with all the school closures. And I believe I learned through David Paulides that the Las Vegas schools were reopened because the high number of high schools Las Vegas students are committing suicide. Now, on one hand, yes, I'm a cold-hearted bastard, and I believe, yeah, survival of the fittest, man. You should fucking toughen up, pansy. On one hand, I am like that. But, you know, there's people that everyone's different. You know, I grew up without a dad, and for the majority of my childhood, my greatest PE teachers and survival school teachers that I still have today, whose effect I still have today. Situational awareness are my high school bullies, junior high school bullies. And those are like with the junior high school bullies, like, yeah, we're civilized in class, but as soon as that fucking bell rings, motherfucker, run. And I was like, motherfucker, I'm a gazelle, let's go, let's do this. Unfortunately, negotiate your way out of it, fucking keep under the radar, and just learn how life was like, because out here and after high school, in the really real world, it's still the same shit. Out here, the bullies will hit you with a gun, a knife, repeatedly over and over your fucking head. And, you know, you see how some kids, you know, they commit suicide. Should even have the fucking school shooters, fucking people that turn to criminals, drug addicts, all sorts of shit, right? Because kids don't, as Dan Penny would say, kids do not lack creativity, they lack leadership. And when you see kids just say, anywhere on social media, piece of shit Twitter, communist Twitter app, stupid Instagram post, TikTok, oh, I've been bullied, oh, this is racial, this is unjust. I'll sum up the way how I feel with those things. Someone recently, someone of my old clients, recently, and she brought in her, let's say her niece, 14 or 15 years old. And she says, "Man, you know, I really wish I could draw, but I can't." I'm cool with my client. I'm not real, real close. But I told the little girl, like, don't fucking say that. I didn't say, "Oh, you know what? You should really not think like that. Like, you know, just hour of power and like, just do it." No. I said, "Don't fucking say that. Don't fucking think like that." And again, I've had a lot of dirt kicked in my face, stabbed in my back. Left for dead. Betrayed. Disappointed. And, you know, people that I've, you know, loved, people that call themselves friends or family. And I think right now I have enough reasons to go buy some heroin, crystal, smoke crack, to go kick a puppy. I guess I have enough rage or hurt or pain to do that. Then I think, oh, and all that shit sucks. And I'm still here, dude. You know, and the good thing from earning this title, one of the beautiful things, you learn how this suffering, this pain is temporary. It's temporary. Yeah, it sucks. So what? Go on. You seem a bit callous, but you don't understand my feelings. They really, really, really hurt. Can't believe you're laughing at my feelings. All right, let's go back to David Paulides. But when he mentions all COVID deaths, suicide rates, depression, the unexplained, people disappearing, he's not, I'm going to say he provides interesting facts and stories to a fucking boring subject. People just vanish. It's not like someone opened up a Stargate to another dimension, brought up 5 Bigfoots and killed unit of special forces in the military from the Israeli Mossad. And it was caught on video and something like that. No, just you know, acknowledging the unexplained danger out there. Fucking highly suspect, unexplained, out of this world stuff. And it's just a snippet. It's almost like a trailer to an amazing movie. It probably leaves him more with wonder and awe than, oh, that's cool. Like, but I call it boring because it's simply but for example, here's one story that I remember where it was a hunter, I believe hunting bison, waiting to, I guess, make a kill shot. I'm not sure if it was Idaho or Montana. Looking through the scope, sees the lead bison stop and then turn away. And then he sees a large figure as if it's wrapped in saran wrap, similar to what looks like what Predator looked like in the movie, The Predator. Predator. Bending night cloaked. And you know, just reported that story and you know, and that was it, right? Just a few moments, but you know, how much wonder is there, you know? And there's other stuff. There's so much amazing stuff on it, but it's nothing. Was it more like an amazing Super Bowl commercial? I'm so used to having a documentary well explained. And, but that's just me being a spoiled motherfucker. Wanting to see the ending of the movie, chapters 1, 2, and 3, the prequels, and director's cut. It could be it. But anyways, I can't tell you exactly what it was that made him get that YouTube strike. And I believe it's 3 YouTube strikes and your channel's done. And if you see me in the comment section throughout YouTube or the videos that I make, look, I'll say, to sum it up, fuck Joe Biden, fuck Obama, fuck Pelosi, and if you think that I'm a Republican, fuck Bush, fuck Fauci, arrest Fauci, don't get the vaccine, and, you know, work out, be fit, you know, if you're not so strong or so young or not in a big gym, just man, walk down to the store and pick up a soda pop. Just at least if you're going to get beef fat and greasy, at least earn the treat if you're not doing exercise. And people say, well, man, it's so cold, it's so hot. It's, I'm like, man, to me, it'd be like, hey, one man walked on that way. Is there a wall? Grand Canyon? Probably taking a bit longer to reach the destination. But it's possible. And yeah, David Paulides reports important things, man. One story that made me tear up was a story of a boy who went with his, I believe, dad and grandfather. I want to say it was the Smoky Mountains. Met another family there. His son went and played hide and seek with the other kids. They did. He sees him hide behind a bush. How's it go? All the oxen free. Came over, show yourselves. And he didn't. His son did not emerge from behind the bush. And he goes to a dead sprint towards his son. He's not there. Keeps on running. Runs back to his father, which is the kid's grandfather, to call the park ranger, cops, services, get some help, and the dead, search and rescue. I believe the name of the family was called the Key family, who running distance on the same day, same afternoon, was asking another park ranger about getting directions to where to go. Where they go see a bear. They believe they see a bear running on 2 feet with something over its shoulder. At the same time, FBI was involved, came in and looked at the kid, did not make all the knowledge available for the investigation until years later. One of the father who did not want to think about this case because it's been so hard on him and his wife, and didn't know about that sighting by the FBI. And the sad part is that the father and mother of the missing boy, they've never changed addresses, though they never changed their address in case the boy came back and wanted to go home and wanted to be home with his family. I believe this happened in the 1950s. But yeah, David Plyers reported that story, and I was like, again, I don't have kids. And I see a lot of legal and mental abuse with kids. Sometimes something that's like slight physical abuse. Hey, no, I told you not to do that, stupid. You fucking dumb. I'm thinking this kid's probably like 5 years old, bitch. And if I was to fucking hit this motherfucker with something and dislocate his jaw, that's assault on me, and the kid would be traumatized and he'd be in prison, his channel would stop. And that'd be an ineffective life outcome. So when Paulides reports of a dad that, let me look for my blue here, reports of a dad that spends time with his son to go out in nature, be a fucking regular kid, man, be alive. And he disappears. Unexplained ways, and yeah, man, it's pretty fucked. And just well, again, look, we're in a scamdemic, pandemic, and something out there that's not being said, told, reported, shared, considered blocked, considered and or blocked. And I believe it's the complete truth. I do believe that the New World Order, the elites, you can't just say it's the Rockefeller Foundation or the Clintons, but there are definitely dark souls out there that right now is the perfect time, most effective time to round us up, kill the majority of us, make profit off of us, higher rents, medical costs, living in fear, inflation, and the like. Yeah, but check him out. His YouTube video is, his YouTube channel is, I believe, Canam. So C A N A M. Missing. Canam missing. Yeah, just check them out. Canada missing David Paulides, or just missing 411. Yeah, I bring it up because it bugs me. Don't doubt that once AI gets better, I'll also be banned from Facebook. I'm already am banned from Facebook, but. And from YouTube. And then, you've seen the shit that I post, right? But for some people, that's racialist. That hurts my feelings. That's offensive. And any one of my viewers who. Well, let's travel a bit. Let's travel a bit. Not just out of your city, but out of your state. No. There's worse stuff out there, man. Should just listen to David Paulides and just good people. See anyone? I'm not fucking with no one, robbing anyone, hurting anyone. I'm just going for the nature walk and appreciate being alive. And next thing you know, they're just gone. Probably. Gone or dead. Can you help? It's finally done. I'm thinking about the flask, but that's all that needs to be done. And any touch ups or mixing. That's it for now. Trump 2024. And remember, when the going gets tough, let's go, Brandon.